smoke. Old stogies I have found, short but not too big around. I'm a man of means by no means, king of the road.
All right, guys, welcome back to another Stogie Lads video. This time we are in a completely different setting. We do not have a cigar review. We are actually in the car. Do you want to tell them where we're going?
Yeah, we're on our way to Bergstrand Cigars, the northernmost tobacco farm, or cigar farm, sorry.
In the world, yeah.
In the world, yeah.
So it's actually one of the two cigar producers we have in Sweden, and really unique. We are sort of in the middle of the country in a place called Dalarna.
Yep.
So we're really high north to be producing cigars.
Exactly. We've been there one time before. Yeah. It was last year, and now we're on our way back, and hopefully, like, getting a bigger tour of what they're doing there.
Yeah, so they're going to show us some of the production, show us what they do, how to produce cigars in Sweden. It's a really interesting topic, and hopefully, we will get to share this tour with you guys.
Yeah.
So that's what we're planning on doing today. We'll be back when we get there, and we'll introduce the two wonderful ladies that run the production at Bergstrand. So yeah. See you guys in a bit.
All right, guys, we just arrived to Bergstrand Cigars and met with the two people here who are yeah, who runs this place, and just walk around here and show you a bit. So here we have the plantation.
As you can see, it's a really it's a small scale, really high quality production here. How many plants do you have?
500.
Oh, 500 wow. Plants.
Oh, so there's some here, and then there's another farm?
400 here.
400 oh, wow. Here. So there's a lot more than actually it looks like.
You can see these big leaves here. Truly cool sight.
So obviously in Sweden, it's not what people would associate with an ideal sort of climate for growing cigars. Obviously the harvest season, we just were informed that it's very short actually. It's only once a year.
Yeah.
Unlike the tropical countries where...
Three times per year.
So they have to get it done over our short and quite cold summer here in Sweden.
Right, so just taking a look here at the soil of which the plants stand on, you can see that it has like a reddish color here, and it's very important for the growth of these plants because it includes a lot of minerals and that allows it to grow like this.
Yeah, so from the understanding is that that really is kind of more key than how far north we are.
Yeah.
And that's sort of how they actually are able to against, I guess, the odds being so high up north, actually produce the tobacco here, which is such a cool thing to be able to see.
All right, so we were just told here that these plants, first of all, are 3 to 4 weeks before harvest.
So they get really, really tall then. They must get, I mean, they are quite big. I mean, it's striking how half-size now.
Half-size, yeah, you
so
can
that's,
see.
It's really striking how just a large plant tobacco is. I mean, the leaves are
I haven't been near
tobacco plants that have, last year when we were here, it was much earlier, so they were just tiny shrubs.
Yeah, exactly.
And we were informed about the blend, which they claim to be a secret blend that we won't dive deeper into to out that. But they said that the seeds is a sort of hybrid between a Cuban, Dominican, and a Canadian
for the to handle the frost here at the northern latitude we're at.
So that's really interesting. Really interesting blend there, and I'm sure that makes it completely unique, along with the terroir here it's, you can't replicate this Swedish soil anywhere else.
No.
It's a really, really unique sort of growing situation here. So we just talked a little more here, and beautiful backdrop, by the way, with the tobacco.
Exactly.
These 500 plants make about roughly 1,500 to 2,000 cigars, and the blend is sort of a mixture of different years. Mm-hmm. So it's a lot of work. It's only these two lovely ladies, Lotta and Gunilla, that work here and roll. So it's about 10 cigars a day, which takes about 3 hours.
Yeah.
So it's a lot of work to roll all these 1,000 cigars.
Yeah.
And speaking of rolling, if you come here, they actually offer a few activities.
Yeah. So they have like a guided tour where you can just hear about like from the first seed like that was planted to like the finished product of the cigar, and even to roll your own cigar, which is quite a cool experience.
I believe. It's not an everyday sort of thing to do, really. So that's very cool.
And just see like the craftsmanship that goes into every single cigar. Mm-hmm.
And then here, as you can see, the bar area here, you can sort of smoke cigars and mm-hmm. drink rum or other sort of beverages.
Pairing.
Yep. And obviously you can always buy their cigars here, which I actually have.
Yeah.
Last year
saving
I bought
it for a while.
Yeah, I want to have that for a special occasion.
Yeah.
And they have some other really nice things in the house over here, where we will show a bit from now.
So here's the short filler cigar from 2018 and 17.
A petite Corona.
Petite Corona. And here's the long filler, 2018 and 2019.
So some honorable employees, we just got told that, yeah, everything is, they have a real focus on how everything is very natural and produced just locally. So even the fertilizer is by these hens that they have here.
About 20 of them that do their duty.
So yeah, great employees of the company. A little funny.
How they look, the plants when they're fully grown, you can see how tall they get. And the plants that we showed outside, those are 3 weeks away from something like this. Look at the size of these leaves.
All right, we just rounded off here our little trip.
Fantastic.
And
absolutely,
yeah,
fantastic process.
Like, this is such an amazing place, and they've built it like from scratch.
Yep.
Like with their own, they were explaining that this farm here, it was like filled with rocks and stuff, so they had to first dig everything out, empty with the rocks, and then fill it again.
Yeah, these two ladies have done everything by hand. I mean, it's really striking how much work, time, effort, and just investment has gone down to this incredible project.
But you can
project.
See how much they love like doing it as well.
Yeah.
Even though they say like from now to like February, it's just like full on work with rolling and everything.
10-hour days.
And, yeah, dedication. To these products, and it's really good to see that people are coming here and like are interested.
Yeah, so we want to say we came here just because it's an incredible, I mean, this is not like a paid promotion or anything.
No, exactly.
This is just a really cool place, and honestly, as a cigar smoker, if you are in Sweden or if you're anywhere near here, do visit, because
definitely.
It's just such a even if you don't buy anything, it's just to see this cigar production in Sweden, up north here,
and to hear like from the people doing it it's truly,
it's so cool. It's such a special thing to see.
Yeah,
so
just to hear about it and the way they talk about it, it's amazing.
Yeah, definitely come around if you're ever in the area.
Yeah,
and that'll be it from us on this trip.
Thank you, Bergstrand, and
thank you guys for watching.
I have found short but not too big around. I'm a man of means by no means.